Joining us via Skype is Dr. Femi Lawson, Director, Center for Public Accountability. Pleasure to have you on the news.
Good morning.
Good morning. Looking at the development now, do you think the easing of the lockdown has been productive?
Well, fundamentally, if you look at the number of cases that have so far been recorded, between the time the lockdown was first declared in the major cities of Lagos, Abuja, and the neighboring state of Ogun, you realize that the outcome has not been as positive as expected, you know, by the government and even the citizens. What we have seen is a spontaneous rise in the number of cases of COVID-19 from less than 100, you know, in the first week of April, to over 3,000. Do you understand? In May. And it tells us that even the lockdown has not been able to progressively achieve the desired goal. And you cannot but also identify that the lockdown in so many places, particularly in Lagos and Ogun, were not as effective as anticipated. So it has not practically addressed, you know, the essence of the lockdown, which was to, you know, slow down the spread of this virus, to reduce the rate of infection. You know. But what we have had is the other way around.
Would you expect the lockdown to be reimposed following threats by the Lagos State government? They are saying that if people continue to flout the directive on social distancing and wearing of masks, that decision is most likely. And on a scale of 1 to 10, how strongly do you feel about the reimposition of this lockdown and the likelihood?
You see, it is, of course, the position of the government may have been born out of, you know, the passion of the governor, you know, to ensure that, you know, we are able to tackle this hydra-headed monster, you know, called coronavirus. But the truth is that in whatever we are doing, we must understand that this is a democracy and there are limitations to some of these steps that can be taken by government. For instance, we cannot wholesomely copy the approach of other countries in addressing, you know, coronavirus pandemic via, you know, shutting down the economy, locking down the societies, without taking same measures that have been taken by these, you know, societies to address the consequences of locking the citizens, you know, for a number of weeks and months that we have experienced. The truth is that the lockdown practically become unsuccessful at a point that the citizens can no longer cater for themselves. We must always understand that you are talking about a population where over 80% are daily wages earner. People who, without working on a daily basis, may not be able to eat. So it is not, and it's a society where there's no social security, you know, infrastructures are not reliable. So we may not awesomely, you know, want to believe that it will work the way it has worked in other places. But like I keep saying, despite the efforts of government, the citizens have the most fundamental role to play in ensuring that we slow down the spread of coronavirus. And what do I mean? Government will not come and enforce social distancing. Government will not come and, you know, enforce that, you know, you don't go out when not necessary. Government will not come and enforce that, you know, we should manage the way we gather around the market. Look at what happened across the banks in Lagos State when the state economy reopened on Monday. So these are the roles that citizens must actively play. But there, you see, on the part of government, reintroducing a lockdown, as, you know, threatened by the Lagos State government, may not easily be the way out or may not achieve the desired result. Because one of the, you know, things that had made the previous lockdown not to be successful was the role of the security agencies. Has the state government been able to address this before we begin to, you know, threaten another lockdown? The government must also look at not the role of the citizens alone, but the role of other stakeholders in the fight against coronavirus who have also compromised, you know, what would have made the lockdown effective. For instance, in some cases, you know, we have had a situation whereby the interstate lockdown were not effective. Let me give you an instance. For the case index cases of lockdown in Jigawa State and Adamawa State, where people who traveled from Lagos to those states during the Lagos lockdown, how was this possible for somebody to have traveled from Lagos to Yola, from Lagos to Dutse, in the course of a lockdown. It tells you that the security agencies were, you know, have compromised their role. They have allowed movement unnecessarily. And this has, of course, complicated the situation, not only for Lagos, but other states that are now witnessing this pandemic. So that is why I think there must be serious engagement on the part of the citizens and the, you know, and the government. In how much more is government engaging the civil society in this? Very low. In some cases, not even at all. Because we need to engage the communities. How much more are we engaging the religious organizations that are now on holiday? Today, we live in a society whereby a lot of our people listen more to their imams and their pastors more than the government. How much more have we been able to engage these religious leaders to let the citizens know the need for them to comply with the directives of the health authorities? All right. So the government cannot do it alone. And under a democracy, some of these fiat decrees may not be able to work successfully. Government must engage key stakeholders in order to ensure that it achieves the desired results.
All right. The Bauchi State government just announced a journalist, though they did not disclose the name of the journalist, has become a victim of the COVID-19 virus. And we know that that is not the first person that's a journalist to get that infection. After doctors and other essential workers, journalists are among those that are likely at high risk of contracting the virus. What is your thought on how journalists and their administrators can better prevent them, help them to reduce the rate, the possibility of exposure?
Well, I think fundamentally, at the stage we are now, media organizations, healthcare delivery organizations, and even the government should by now, you know, have established a special, you know, scheme that would take care, in terms of insurance, people who are at the front line during this period of this pandemic. Only recently, do we have few states, you know, raising the emoluments, you know, the payments, you know, allowances for health workers and nurses and doctors. In some cases, some have not even raised, you know, their payments, you know, their allowances, despite the rigorous works that they are doing during this pandemic. And the journalists are also on the front line, because most of the reportage of what has been happening, as far as the pandemic is concerned, most of the advocacy, the education, has been done by the media. So the government and stakeholders, you understand, and even employers of this category of, you know, frontline workers must devise an, you know, intervention, an urgent one for that matter, that will take care, you know, not only the health, you know, of the people who are on the front line, that perhaps if they have, in case of the eventuality, something untoward happens, there must be something that would be sufficient enough to take care of their family if eventually the unexpected happens. So this should not be seen as a regular period of work for journalists and other frontline workers, you know, working 24 hours, you know, monitoring and covering this pandemic. There must be special, you know, packages. There must be special steps that must be taken by the government and the employers to ensure. And, you know, most importantly also is the issue of the PPE. Everybody that is exposed to, you know, coronavirus, you know, patients, whether as a reporter, whether as an healthcare worker, must be protected. And, you know, the lack of this protective equipment may hamper not only the zeal of this, you know, media the journalists to cover effectively what is happening around the issues of this pandemic. It may also, you know, of course, like we have already experienced in Kano, it's already demoralizing the zeal of the medical and healthcare workers. Right. And you have found doctors and nurses absconding from duty. So we must make sure that we prioritize the health and the safety of these healthcare workers and journalists who are on the front line at this very period.
All right, before I let you go, let's talk about the monies that has been received during this period. How would you assess the level of transparency and accountability as regards the management of the funds donated towards fighting this pandemic?
Well, it's a thank you. Only a few days ago, we heard the federal government saying that, you know, donations received are going to be used to fund, you know, the supplementary budget in 2020. I think that's fundamentally wrong. I want to disagree with the government on that, because these are special funds. raised for the purpose of addressing the pandemic that is ravaging the land. And the government must be prudent in ensuring that these funds are majorly, you know, channeled towards the purpose for which they have been raised. And this goes to other state government. Only a few days ago, the local state government came out with a list of donors that have contributed, you know, to funds to tackle this coronavirus pandemic. This is commendable. Other states are enjoined to take a clue from this. But overall, beyond, you know, reeling out the names of donors, beyond reeling out the amount of money that have been raised, you know, our other equipment and facilities that have been gathered as support towards fighting this scourge, government and every other person involved in the fight against COVID-19 must ensure that at the end of it all, we must give account of every kobo spent in this war.
All right,
because we have had experiences in the past where, till date, you know, Ebola funds are still improved in so many countries.
All right,
I need to interject now.
That's
pandemic.
All time will permit us on the program. Thank you very much for your thoughts and insights.
It's my pleasure.